You're gonna see I'm just a big phony and a loser.
Oh, boo-hoo. Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
This is serious.
I know. This really is the world's smallest violin. See?
I've just finished building the tiny violin from this scene, and I'm gonna show you how I did it. But before that, it looked like this. And before that, it looked like this. Our first attempt at the tiny violin didn't go so well. Not only does it make your ears bleed, but most importantly, it plays like an amputated dog. It can't pause. More accurately, the choice of hardware and what I thought was the only supporting sound library at the time did not have a pause button. Looking back, I could have used this one instead, and very likely didn't have to do a hardware revision I didn't even need. I've tried to do this without a pause and just use a stop instead, but it just breaks the illusion.
Excuse me, with dealing with everything we have to do with, look.
To maintain the illusion of playing a tiny violin, our build needed to do at least these three things. One, music needs to pause and resume. Two, music must play when your fingers move, and three, the violin needs to be contactless. And we've managed to do all three in the Mark II by practicing a timeless software engineering strategy, by making it hardware's problem. Need a pause and a resume? There's hardware for that. Music must play when fingers move? There's hardware for that. Pent up and lonely at home? I'm sure there's hardware out there that can be strapped together. By throwing tons of hardware at the problem, we've ended up with a working yet bulky solution. All that remains now is to pack all of this into its final form factor.
Three, two, one, go!
And here we are, 6 months of binging Makertail tutorials, 3D modeling, and stealing a laser from the local makerspace, compressed into 60 seconds. The cost of having a hardware-heavy design really shows here, as we needed to model every component to figure out the smallest box to house it all. To top it off, we had to learn modeling too. But in the end, this was worth it just to do this. Thanks for watching. I'll eventually leave a how-to video here if you feel like building your own violin, but before then, feel free to cringe out at my earlier work.